dive straight into our, of course, a talk regarding what next after PLE, and of course, what are the kids are going to be doing with themselves, and of course, a couple of advice that will be coming in from us, understanding the fact that we have gone through that step. We want to take you back to a story that we did read about regarding the 12 students that were arrested after they sat for PLE when they were not supposed to sit for these exams. Now, also news coming in as far as this particular story is concerned is that these were students from a secondary school that were hired by a particular school to just come and sit for certain individuals who at that point were dumb or couldn't be able to sit for these examinations. Let's check out details coming in from this story.
Out of wanting to help, mbayagala kuyamba, I'm insisting on to wandika erinya. Yagezo kukulaba ngerinya lya wandika, ate siri eriri ku identical ye ddala. So the other ones were forcing okuwandika ne bawandika amannya. Now, mu kukompayira n'empapula, bagenda okulaba nga there are some names that are duplicated. Now they're appearing twice, the same everything. That's how they come to know. Okujja okutegeera nti obwedda mulimu abantu bana abasekendi abatuuliddewo abaana bana abalala kati ate bali ne bawandika amannya g'abaana abasekendi abasekendi ne bawandika amannya g'abali kiteberezebwa okuba nti abasekendi bo bagezeko okusinga bali be bawandise be batuuliddemu so nti bano bajja performinga bulungi okusinga bali nti bana abasekendi bali abaperforminga obubi nibo banawandiika amannya ag'abaana abasekendi tebalina kyebaluzimba kubanga bo examination si yaabwe so bwe tutyo ne tubakwata babadde bagenda baduplicatinga so bali bali 12 ne tubakwata ne tubakwasa poliisi poliisi nitali kukunoonyereza olwaleero tubasuubira mu kkooti saawa yonna
ngoli awanisa erinnya ly'omwana wange No. I don't know. Wanti akole ekirala. Fe tuvunaanyizibwa eri headmaster. Yalina otubuulira. Ki ekigenda mu maaso.
Nze gwe natwalira omwana nakukwasa headmaster. Gwe nsasula ssente. Kati ongamba otwala omwana mu kkooti naani? Pepa yagiggyebwa.
Ye
yayingira atya mu ssomero eri?
I think the parents are actually bringing up a very interesting, kind of conversation here. Who is responsible for this? When, you take your child to school, you have given them whatever requirements they need. And for you as a parent, you believe they are ready to actually sit for these examinations. But at the end of the day, the head teacher of a particular school just tries to play around with this and, have this, mercenaries come to sit for your daughter or your son's examination, and at the end of the day your son is implicated in this kind of situation. Who is particularly to blame for all this?
First of all, I want to blame whoever brought this arrangement, because the person is stupid. Like, they're just stupid.
I mean, it's the school and, like, the head teacher.
I believe if you're going to pull off a long con like that, then start it from the jump. Have these kids already in your school, right? Babereho musomero P6, P5, bunga mubalabanga, amanya baga wandisa, down to your name. Ngo abachimanyi tugenda kolera mu mulinya lya Derek kuba ye musiru. So olinda ko. So in the
kolinda ko, linda ko. Za yo statement sa ko salinya lya ange. Bintu byo kugileka. So ko ze ye linya lya ange. Ko sa Willis.
Ah, I need that. Aonja kuba kusho. Nja kuba kusho.
So I believe Kati, so that when it's time for PLE, this child has already been accustomed to who he's supposed to be playing. So he's going to write down your child's number and everything. I don't think the other child was supposed to even be in the class. But yeah, that's besides the point. Back in the day, I never used to believe it, apart from people from Chitende. But I just used to think it is not the schools. I used to think it is the parents
But from what we are seeing, it turns out to be the school, because the parents are literally green. They don't know how that incident did happen.
So the school gains in terms of botwara yo mwana oba kugamba twina first grade yana.
Yanti yes, manyama somero gachero kufuna mubwega tu. Results bazifuluma ne bagamba Njeru primary, they have 50 candidates in division 1.
Because baba tv baba Widisi.
Yeah, buyikweyo. Widisi.
See what?
Given your background of
being I was on this show. I was on this show.
And the incident that is happening.
And I was advising parents. To have questions they ask schools before they have their children admitted.
I know, yeah.
In this case, you needed to have asked the school, ngoino kubuze somero. Headmaster waline somero, degree jaina. Ya nasa, ya makerere, ya chambogo, ya UCU, ya wa. Omanyeti headmaster ono, degree eje ya funa njirabieko. Newe avanti ya li pass degree yeno. So you know that this headmaster stands in line with having kids getting actual results.
A real education.
Those are questions that we need to ask. Yes. We just don't need to take for granted the headmaster has a good office, so therefore it means that the school is also good. No, some of these guys are goons behind desks and, you know, leading this country into all sorts of mess. So coming back to when you ask who should we blame, we need to blame UNEB.
Okay. Really?
Yes.
How? Why are we even blaming
UNEB?
Here is the trick. When UNEB registers 35 students from your school,
why
it provides 35 papers.
That's
no,
true.
No, no.
Your school.
They always bring, there's always...
There's no extra. If you are
exactly
35, they even call you before you start. They tell you come and check.
Oh yeah, I remember.
And then you check, there are 35.
Yes.
It is even written on. Then they open the seal. You count them, there are 35.
So
if there are 37.
Why are you sitting 40 students?
Exactly. Why are 40 students in the examination room?
And why do you have extra if they registered 30?
Yes.
So that means... At some point, if all of you are
someone at your name was involved. Either at the district level somewhere, someone at your name
to bring
was
excess
involved. You have 40 students in a place of 35 students. Someone knew. Because they should not have left that issue to go to writing names on papers.
Exactly.
They should have raised the red flag there and then.
To sitting for the papers.
But then that is where I blame the school. Kana itetuganye bali bageza ako kupa na iba ako pabu vini.
Ati ba ako pabu.
Zamagezi genandi ba wade. This is what they would have done.
Your Ugandaness is coming
out. My Ugandaness is coming out.
Ngaba wakora. Ata magezi gaba wa.
Nzali msaje ya somako. Gana magezi geno kuwa out of research. Given my job background. Eti nchaba andiko ze chintu changu nyo. Ndaba wa somesisa. Ndaba wa director wa kutepe. Chwa andiko ze chintu changu nyo. Buma ancho ina wili simusiru. Wili simugambe, wili stoja. Na ya ateka tuboi no kuimbo.
Eti fana ni. Eti fana ni.
Ate impijireka. Impijireka manyetu fana nita wili
si. Chokola.
Kubanga you see on the answer sheet. You do not write your name.
You write your
it is your index number. So what you do, we quote it fana ncha Derek Omugezi. Choboteka ku idea wili so musilu.
Nasaro.
Ogambe wili sisigale waka. Kati wano mku indigile ntinga. Baja kunda gawa na akafana. Kati hanti chen kugamba kati wano kulira mwono za de.
Nenda, omwana muleka veye kagwenge somero guba gwa gendo okuba.
Omukweke.
Omukweke mudo.
Mwepa oli musilu gena mfumbide. Bereyo.
Jobotu.
Abereyo katono wili. Omugeza ingileo.
Atule pepa agende. Ne what are we doing really?
No, ati... What do you want mobia banoga na imwa baby of course the school is also to blame.
Everyone is to blame.
I mean the headmaster, the director of studies, and the teachers who are, you know, supposed to invigilate, because they knew that this so and so is not in this school, so and so is in secondary school. But if the invigilator should have been patriotic enough to say,
the thing though for me is, I was going to say that these kids actually do not deserve to be put in lockup, that it's the it's the teachers and the schools and whoever it is, but no. On second thought, no. Baba Twaleke can't be in Sabali Mire Miezejo.
No, this kid should not be taken to.
No, listen. So that the next time a teacher from another school comes to your secondary school and says, Jango to Lido Mana P7. O Jagambangende can't be in Gisa. Ndai, Dimu S1 on the country.
But when you saw Sao,
Nada Baba Twaleke can't be in
children's rights. They should have just. There and then go down for 20. There and then down.
Corporal punishment.
How did they convince this child to leave their secondary and come and
they give you money?
They give them money.
They give you 40k, 50k. 50k, how much is that for a
secondary? What are you going to
be,
no, if you're in S2?
In Njeru.
No, it's not good, okay. You're in S2 in Njeru, first of all. S2, we all know that is the class where. Not to do jinga classes on a daily, like you'll attend two lessons a day, and it could probably be geography or history just to pass time, right? So Omana, so Omana at that time, Momugamba, go and sit for a P7 examination.
They give them very little money, and for all for what? To just try and raise, marks for the school, which also goes back to our education system. Do we have weak teachers? They are failing to teach these kids.
They are taking shortcuts.
Yes, they are taking shortcuts. Omuja teacher avude makerere. Aise mu shortcuts. Omwado omulimu mu primary school. They don't know what they are teaching. They don't know how to teach the
kids.
And
they don't really care.
Yeah, so the kids reach P7 and they are angers. So the headmaster also, Bambi, it's a business. Akamba, look at all these pigs. Our children are pigs that are hard.
I need my
power. No, but anyway, after
this... At the end of the day, all I can say is that it's true for Chirinti. Let's understand one thing. The other guy we hosted here sometime back was talking about our education system. And he said it, and he said, you see, binebibuzo binebikubu since our class. Binebidio causing us such problems. Because the pressure is too much on the child just to skip one particular class. Listen, and he gave me his own understanding, and he's like, if we can make it all the way from P1, mpaka wo malira, basically what we'd call secondary school, no vuga wo kalamba. Kalamba. For all the years. And trust me, I'll give you the mathematics behind it, and it works.
I honestly respect that school of thought, but I would say this in just 40 seconds, that you need, these are children, these are young people. Ne obirango ino mwane waka, ngagena kuata mubuji, tomugama antigenda, woliku lorima nanti vocha, auwe nyini. So you need someone in P1 to say, oh, ina papers, suma, bikwate mutwe, revise. So chigasa nyoku watu to ina P1, P2.
Nene babantu wa inde mnava tukarabi. Rache mtu tusuma P1.
There's a paper that
they just turned
it was I don't know if it was a duplicated paper or something, but it leaked and the questions were there. I'm like, I was here pushing my son to read very hard in Gavino.
Now, PLE is done, of course. Unfortunately, such of the instances have happened, and we shall wait and see how the police handles this one together with your neighbor. And what next for these kids that have been arrested sitting in for fellow students as far as their PLE is concerned? But now, what next for our students who actually went through this, sat for their 2 days, and now they're happily enjoying their vacation. Mm.
First of all, mm. I'd like to say I only knew one P7 candidate, and mm. that happens to be his son. Mm. So, hi, Gabe. I don't know if he's already awake. I know he's awake.
I don't think so.
I know he's awake. and congs to them, you know, congs to them. I remember how it felt like the day you were doing your last paper. You couldn't believe that finally the pressure is going to be down. Okay, it was a lie because when we entered S1, they gave us beginning of term. But
which school is
man,
that?
Man, I was in a very harsh school.
So what were they asking you?
I don't even remember, but there was an exam of some
sort. Remember the only exam I did in senior one, the first term was end of term.
Wow.
Dude.
There was beginning of term, my
there
friend.
There was beginning of term.
After 3 weeks, beginning after of term.
Yes, in senior one, first term, and that's the term that I was expelled, but let us leave it.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Yeah, but now we're talking about vacation. You know, these kids have been under so much pressure. Mm-hmm. It's been books. I've been seeing his son. No holidays. They don't come back home for holidays. When they do come back home, it's just for like about 2-3 days. Mm. Go back. The pressure has been crazy. First of all, for the parents out there, just give these kids just a week. Don't say a month. No, a week. But after a week, they get bored. They're going to try and look for what to do. I would encourage, like, what my son wants to do in his vacation. He says he's going to go knock at people's gates and just say, hello, my name is so-and-so. I live up the street. My mother's name is this. Can I wash your car for a fee? Because he's trying to save up to buy himself a bicycle. I'm like, that's good. I mean, don't just let them be potato heads, you know, just slouch on the couch and watch TV. No. You can encourage them to do things. You can help gardening at home. Teach them a simple skill during their vacation. Because, we all know, secondary is not
it's a
for
trap.
That.
It's not really it was just
for
a trap.
Willis, wrap up with this one. Wrap up with this
for
one.
For me, I'd say one is that as a parent, you're very excited. Mm. Even before they see their exams, you're like, what's this guy going to do? I think he should do this. I think he should do this. So you're very excited. Mm. So when they come home, and I must say I'm also a culprit of that, you sit down and say, so, that very day, what do you want to do?
Let them take it in.
You will be shocked as a parent what these kids are thinking about. Mm. The child who's just sat for their papers is thinking, I want to go and swim, I want to go for a trip, I want to go see my friends, I want PS, I want this, I want that. So it's only healthy for a parent to just listen out to the kids and just give them what they want. Mm-hmm. You want to go and swim? Go and swim tomorrow. You want to go and do this? Do this. But you also have to put it in mind that at some point you need, this is a time for
Rain
you to impact life. Sustaining skills on the children. Mm-hmm. You have to think about holiday packages of catering, holiday packages of music school, holiday packages of football, tennis. So you have to sit down with your child and identify it. Umwana mundabi yangi, umwana yasama nyo, umwana yagira nyo. Kamtuale ku new vision. Bamuteke public speaking skills. Alabike nti moko kwasa mayasa mira kunsonga. Si kwasa manga wa full figure. So you need to learn your kid. This is the time. P7 vacation is the time for you to engage your child in a life, in a long-term skill to send you no mwana. So this is the time for you. But for the first 2-3 weeks, let them have a blast. Let them be reckless. Of course, within bounds, but let them be reckless and just enjoy something.
Reckless in a marginalized manner.
Yes.
There you have it. Of course, all you can do is as well, that is very simple, in case you want to be part of this conversation of what next after these kids have sat for their PLE. Get over to our Facebook page, which is Urban Television, and of course, you'll find a post there for our Kacha, and you can leave a comment, and we'll definitely dive into that a little bit later on. We're going for a very quick break, but when we do get back, the second hour of the show, we begin it with the love letter.